Engineers move through a series of steps to design a product or artifact to solve a problem. In our case, this is a hydraulic structure that it's feasible to construct, to operate and maintain, and that meets the functional requirements. Major steps in the engineering design process are: define the problem, specify the functional requirements, sketch and describe preliminary designs, select the most promising designs, test, verify through prototyping or modeling, refine the design or even redesign, select the final design. Now, define the problem. What's the goal? For whom and when is it achieved? This includes defining criteria to be used in the evaluation of the design, for instance, cost-effectiveness. It also involves collating background knowledge on the environment and its dynamic variability. Specify the functional requirements. This involves determining the hydraulic boundary conditions or the forcing which the envisaged structure must withstand or control, and the standard or level to which this should be achieved. The next step involves sketching a design, a first idea of a design, so it's preliminary. In the sketching process, the hydraulic boundary conditions are connected to the form and the character of the structure envisaged to perform the required functions. This is an important step. It's not mentioned explicitly in most descriptions of the engineering design process, and yet it's essential. The preliminary designs are then specified in more detail to establish whether they're practically feasible, can be constructed, operated, and maintained at reasonable cost. Sometimes this specification step brings problems to light, and redesign must occur, or designs are even eliminated from consideration. Then the most promising preliminary designs are selected on the basis of their potential success in meeting the functional requirements and the evaluation criteria. The next step involves detailed testing and verification of the most promising preliminary designs. This can involve building a physical prototype, but nowadays it generally involves detailed calculations and even mathematical modeling and simulation. The final design which emerges is often a modified form of the preliminary design, taking the insights generated in the detailed testing phase into account. So, for instance, the precise orientation of a breakwater to the coast may change following this phase. The final design is selected on the basis of its success in meeting the functional requirements and the evaluation criteria. It's then usually released to tender by construction companies who offer to build the structure, specifying their materials, their construction methods, and determining the associated costs. The design process is usually considered to end here, with the final design being realized. But these steps are not always followed one by one in order. Sometimes an engineer makes a design, but when it's tested, there's a problem. So he or she iterates through the design process, going back to an earlier step to reconsider or even redesign. So iteration between the levels occurs as more detailed knowledge reveals incompatibilities or inadequacies. This means that although the full engineering design process is often depicted as a sequence of steps, it's usually iterative. Some see it as a pyramid, with detailed specification as the foundation. I think of it as a funneling process in which progressive focus towards the selection of the final design is achieved. But what do you think? Enjoy exploring engineering design further.